Psalmist says in Psalm 119 verse 92, unless thy law had been my delight, I should then have perished in my affliction. I will never forget thy precepts, for with them thou hast quickened me. Come on, believer, where are you? You are in a great storm. Are you being plagued with doubt and unbelief because of all this secular humanism that's saying? Have you been overwhelmed by fear with all the craziness going on around the world? Hear the word of the Lord. Unless the word of God becomes your delight, you will perish in your affliction. You have to read it and read it and read it until it begins to bless you, change you, strengthen you, teach you, encourage you, illuminate you, empower you, prophesy to you, deliver you, heal you, bless you. Hallelujah. Unless the Lord had been my delight, he said, I should then have perished. But because the word was his delight, he made it. Because we will return to the word of God, we will make it. We will overcome. You know, they sang that song, we will overcome, you know, during the civil rights marches and movement, beloved. But the song is ours. The word of God is our refuge. The word of God is our strength. The word of God is your answer. Are you depressed? Read the word of God. Are you in trouble? Read the word of God. Are you vexed? Read the word of God. Are you being tempted by sin? Read the word of God. Are you discouraged? Read the word. Read the word, beloved. You see that what you're going through will not defeat you, will not overcome you. You will rise in Jesus' name. I will never, the prophet said, I will never forget thy precepts. For with them thou hast quickened me. The word of God has quickening power. The word of God has help in it. The word of God has grace in it. The word of God has power in it. The word of God has life. Hallelujah. You return to the Bible, beloved, you will see that you will get stronger than your enemies. Return to the word of God, you will see that you will not be seduced by all these strange philosophies you're hearing. Return to the Bible, you will see that life and strength will begin to rise up in you. I'm encouraging you, bishops, apostles, prophets, don't study the word to preach. Study the word to live. Study the word to refresh your soul, refresh your spirit, to strengthen your prayer life, to empower you. Study the word, that's the answer. The word of God is the antidote to all the corruption that is on the earth today. I want to keep hanging here, Psalm 119. We have several weeks in this. Oh, how I love thy law. This is verse 97. It is my meditation all the day. What are you thinking about? I found out that if you meditate on what is going on, it will overwhelm you because you become what you meditate on. But if you keep meditating on the word of God, all of a sudden the Holy Spirit will begin to show you what is happening in the light of what was prophesied. And now you revive. He will begin to show you the power that belongs to us that we are not exercising. And it will bring you back. That's what he did to me. And when I see the way God fought for Israel in the Old Testament, I see that if we meet his standard and become his people, that he will come and fight for us like he did. Beloved, the word of God, it has to be your meditation all the day. If you need a breakthrough, meditate on it day and night. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That brings Joshua 1:8. This book of the law shall not depart. That's what God said to Joshua. It's not even a prophet writing that. That was a direct line. I remember a lady that used to be here. Oh, some of the precious people that went into rebellion. I remember we were at a prayer and fasting meeting. Boy, we get on that Friday night, people were everywhere, even people were sitting by the side of the stage, you know, church was packed. and it was so heavy. It was so oppressive. We couldn't worship. We couldn't do anything. I just felt like running away. Ooh, it was horrible that night. And finally, in desperation, I said, Lord, what is wrong? He said, there are so many people in this room that are not fasting, and they have caused this breach. That's when I heard the word breach. It was from the Lord. I know it's in the scriptures. He said, now, stand up and repent on their behalf, and my glory will come down. Ooh, beloved, I took the mic, and I told them what happened, and I prayed a simple prayer, repenting on behalf of the people, and bang, the fire of God hit. Woo! It was, what a night that was. And this lady came to me and said, Pastor Chika, you are DL. And I said, what is DL? He says, you got a direct line to heaven. This is a direct line, beloved. He said to Joshua, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. He said, thou shalt meditate therein day and night. Watch this, that you may observe to do it. That's what I just said yesterday. Don't meditate on it day and night so you can come up with the latest revelation and preach the most powerful sermon. Most of what I'm doing, beloved, is effortless because I don't read my Bible to preach. I read my Bible for me. The sermons come as an aside. And many times I've been sitting in meetings and I have no sermon. And worship is going on and different people are saying different things. And I just sit there. And all of a sudden it will just come to me. And I'll look up the scriptures and I'm meditating. Sometimes it happens, sometimes I do 3 or 4 services a day. I can't get myself all stressed out and I have to map them all out. No, when you feed your soul and your spirit with the word of God, then God can prophesy to you and God can minister to you. So when you hear all this negative news and see all the craziness going on, you can stand up. Because the word of God will speak to you. The word of God will prophesy to you. The word of God will empower you. And when you do it, he says, you will make your way prosperous and you will have good success. It's the word of God, beloved. We get our own from the word of God. The world gets their own through sin, through compromise, through sinning and selling their soul to the devil. But the word of God gives us our own breakthrough. How much time do you spend in it? You cannot confront the apostates. You can't change anything. You can't even make corrections. You will be wrong and think you are right. That's why believers are the way they are. They don't know the scriptures. Everything is decided from the head. Where are you? Is the word of God still the Lord of your life? Remember, Jesus is the word of God. In the beginning, I will get to it, was the word. May God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.